One, two, three. That was fun. And I'm Mark O'Connor.
I'm Maggie O'Connor.
And we are here for the intermediate class. And we've got just a couple of tips for you as you work this up this week. I want to point out that this has several parts to it, indicated by rehearsal letters, A, B, C, D, all the way down. But there's a couple of techniques that are kind of difficult in measure four. That's a triplet with a sustaining open A string. So it creates a double stop with a triplet on the lower string. That's tricky. Work it out first where you just play it on the single string, on the D string, and then add the open A string after you get that triplet line. And then we've got a kind of a tricky B part with some string crossing.
Yes, it can be very tricky, and stylistically, especially in American music, make sure that you're not playing with your bow strokes too short and don't make them too separated. So try to play a little legato. Even though it's very rhythmic music, it will sound better if you can play legato, but still very much in time. But at letter B, there is a lot of string crossing, so that can be hard to play legato. So you can have a little bit of space, but try to have the illusion that it's still very connected phrasing. But watch out for those string crossing. And then actually at letter E, it's also pretty tricky because there's string crossing, but with double stops. So kind of give your left hand a chance to form the first double stop and then make the switch over to the other strings to make the other double stops that come up after it.
I want to point out in letter D, the third measure in, there's a little dash that indicates a slide with the finger, with the left hand finger, in this case, their first finger. And when you see those little dashes, those diagonal lines, that indicates a half step slide. So basically just start from a B flat note with your first finger and slide into the B natural as indicated there on the sheet music. Then letter F is the repeat of letter B. We've got a DSL coda. So you go back to the beginning, play one time through the first stave and the second stave, then you'll see the little coda sign, and then you follow that down to the very last measure of the piece where a surprise is waiting for you. Rather than a C sharp note to end the piece, we go to a C natural note and a fermata to hold at the end. And good luck learning this piece this week, and we'll see you at the end of the week.